What's up, people? It's your girl Adeola. Have you heard that the mother of Ngozi Okonjo-Iweala was kidnapped? Ha! When I heard, I was so heartbroken. I said, "Kai, like seriously, an 82-year-old woman? Abba, Even if you have something against Ngozi, Ngozi has a lot of younger people that surround her. If you really need to find somebody close to her, not like an 82-year-old woman. You don't know they fear God." Anyway, it was so sad. So when I saw it, I posted it on my Facebook page. I said, "People, this is what is happening. Ngozi's mother has been kidnapped." I was so surprised by what some of my friends were saying. Nasty stuff, can you believe? They were saying things like, okay, now they will know what ordinary people have been going through in Nigeria. In fact, somebody said, so the rich also cry. Like, immediately, I deleted all those people from my friends list. You know, Ngozi's brother released a statement saying, the reason why their mom was kidnapped is because there is no security in Nigeria. Until I read that statement, I had no idea that there was no security in Nigeria. So I tweeted it. I said, this is a revelation. Ngozi's brother has released a statement that it is because there is no security in Nigeria. That's why they kidnapped their mom. Imagine what some people are writing on my Twitter page. Just because it's your mom, that is when you are now realizing that there is no security in Nigeria. We've been shouting all this. I said, people, this is a difficult time. Another person said, so if your mom was not kidnapped, you won't believe there is no security in Nigeria? Which can yeye be this now? I said, people, if you don't have good thing to say, you don't always have to open this your mouth. Sometimes just keep it quiet, okay? Immediately, I deleted those tweets. I said, you people will not cobalize me. Anyway, I started hearing rumors that the kidnappers are demanding for $1 billion. So I asked a couple of my friends. I said, is this true? My friends looked at me like, this cannot be true, Adeola. I said, thank God, $1 billion. Where do they want us to find it? My friend said, this cannot be true because if the kidnappers are just asking for this money, they must be stupid. I said, wait, where are you trying to go? I mean, where are you going? What is your point? My friend said, these kidnappers are missing a great opportunity. They should just tell Ngozi, reverse the subsidy remover. When you reverse the subsidy remover, we will release your mom. We are tired of paying so much for fuel every day in a country that produces oil. I said, Kai, this is the kind of person you are. That was my friend. I was telling my friend. I said, Kai, this is the kind of person you are. You can't feel somebody else's pain when they are in pain. My other friend said, Adeola, what do you mean, feeling somebody else's pain? I said, you two, you are together. My friend said, look at you. They should just tell Ngozi, Ngozi, talk with Jonathan. Whatever you guys need to do. Naira value has really depreciated. Nobody respects Naira anymore anywhere in the world. Do you know that Naira used to be the same amount with dollar? In 1982, I still remember, dollar and Naira used to be the same thing. In fact, Naira used to be more than dollars. Yes. What has happened? Now it's like $1 to 160 Naira. That is very, very bad. My friend said they should just tell Ngozi, you know, you are the finance minister. You've worked at the World Bank for more than 20 years. You have the experience and everything it needs. Whatever you need to put in place, start working on it so that the value of Naira can appreciate. I said, that will take a long time. We want them to keep our mom until she does something. It will take a long time. Now my friend said, let her start from somewhere. So I turned to my third friend. I thought, you know, since he's been quiet the whole time, maybe he will, you know, jump to be on my side. Until he got up on his feet. Oh, you wouldn't believe what he said. He said, Adeola, it's very simple. Instead of fixing subsidy or fixing the value of Naira, just tell her, Ngozi, you know, fix the Lagos Ibadan Express Road. Once that is done, we'll release your mother. I said, my friend said, people are dying every day on that Lagos Ibadan Express Road. Just tell her to fix the Lagos Ibadan Express. I said, she cannot. She won't be the one to fix the road now. How do you think like this? My friend said, she's a minister. She would know who to talk to. And then after they fix the road, the kidnappers can say, by the way, madam, boys need some change now. You know, boys go chop, make you add 1 billion. I said, not after demanding all those things for her to add another billion. By the way, don't say $1 billion anymore. Stop saying $1 billion. That thing annoys me. Where do you want us to get $1 billion? We'll have to go and borrow $1 billion again from China. For those friends of mine that like to just open their mouth anyhow and talk, I told them, I'm no longer coming to this pepper soup joint if you guys don't change the way you think. Kai, it's very, very bad. See, I'm just so glad that they found the woman. Kai, I can't imagine what she went through. And all these guys that have been talking nonsense, I said, where are you? Show your face. They can't show their faces. Now they are hiding. They are ashamed of all that they have said. I said, when somebody is going through trouble, stick with them. That is how life is. Anyway, I'm just, you know, keeping it real. So one of the reasons why I love Zimbabwe is because of all the weird stuff that happened there. Seriously, this story I'm about to tell you is so bizarre. I had to call my brother from Zimbabwe and be like, dude, does things like this happen in Zimbabwe like every so often? I mean, have you ever seen anything like this with your kuro-kuro eyes? My friend was like, oh yeah, Adeola, stuff like this happen in Zimbabwe like every so often. I've seen it with my very own eyes. I was like, oh, okay. So my people, let me tell you what happened. A 31-year-old woman, Immaculate Alice Chirunga, was robbed. They took away her purse, so she went to see a witch doctor. They call it Nanga. And the witch doctor said, oh, don't worry, I'll do my magic and let me tell you, they will return your purse. But not just that, they're gonna add a compensation, like because of all the troubles that they've caused you, they will add some money, yeah. But the witch doctor told her, when they return your purse and the money, don't forget to pay me $350. That's my price for helping you out. She was like, oh yeah, no problem. Anyway, so she went back home and funny enough, they returned her purse. Everything was intact. Not just that, but they added some money, you know, like dollars. Yeah, they spend dollars in Zimbabwe. So they returned her purse and added some money to it. So then she called the witch doctor. And by the way, the witch doctors, they are all on speed dial. I mean, they all have cell phones. I mean, they probably even have iPhones. Seriously? These witch doctors, they really stepped up their game. So they are now on speed dial, you know. Hey, what's up, witch dude? I just got robbed today. Can you do some magic? So she called the witch doctor when the money arrived. She was like, dude, I mean, I really appreciate all the effort and thanks for the love, but I really need this $350 right now. I'm gonna pay you later. I'll pay you next year. She said she would pay the witch doctor in the new year. And my people, that was where the problem began. So, she counted the money, the $350 that was meant for the witch doctor, and she put it on her bed and decided to use the restroom. She decided to go and use the toilet. So when she came back from the toilet, the money was gone, as in it disappeared. Yeah, but instead of the money, there was a bird sitting on the bed. She freaked out. She was like, hey, what's a bird doing in my room? How did the bird get in my room? And so she picked up her phone and called the witch doctor like, hey dude, the money is gone and I just saw a bird sitting on my bed. What's going on in here? And the witch doctor said, oh, don't worry, that's the sekurundoru. Yeah, that's what they call it. Yeah, I mean the bird. He said that's his messenger, that he sent the bird, the sekurundoru, to come and collect the money. The woman was like really shocked. The witch doctor told her, what you have to do now is take the bird to Bachano Bridge. Yes, that's a bridge by the border of Zimbabwe and South Africa. Apparently there's a lot of witchcraft going on around that place. Yes. So anyway, she took the bird, trying to take it to the bridge. But all of a sudden, the bird started talking to her, like real human voice. The bird started talking in human voice. So she was like, oh, what is this? So she called her brother like, hey, bro, you need to save me up in here. A bird is talking to me. So when the brother got there, he was so upset. He was like, why didn't you tell anybody in the family? Why did you have to go and see a witch doctor first? Do you know what happened? The bird looked at the brother and he was like, hey, you, you were not there when we started this journey, so shut up your mouth. Ooh, no he didn't. Yes he did. The brother took to his heels, you know what I'm saying? He ran. If I ever see a bird talking, I would run too, you know. So when the bird wouldn't stop talking, the people started gathering around her like, what is going on in here? Is that a bird talking? So to cut a long story short, they handed her over to the police. So right now she's at police custody, saying that, oh, don't worry, everything will be sorted out as soon as I get the witch doctor. So when I heard the story, I told my friend, I said, you expect me to believe this is true? My friend said, oh yeah, it happened. I said, I'm not saying it's not possible, but if the witches of Zimbabwe are this powerful that they can make a bird talk, I mean, why is Mugabe still in power after 30 something years? Seriously, it's like all these African witches and wizards, they don't know how to channel their power. They always go after the wrong targets. How can you be living below poverty level and Mugabe is living in luxury at the expense of the common people, and all the witches cannot have a meeting on how to get rid of him and, you know, put somebody else there that will care about other people. You know, Mugabe just vowed that he would fight like a wounded beast in this upcoming presidential election just for him to retain power. He was just recently endorsed by his party to be their presidential candidate for the upcoming election next year. Even though he's gonna be 89 next year, which means very soon he will be a 90-year-old man. Imagine, he's still trying to be president. I said, where are the witches? Where are the wizards? When this guy is vowing that he will fight like a beast, where are they? Eh? And you are telling me they are this powerful? I mean, a lot of Africans are really into witchcraft and all that, but we still have all these bad leaders and they've not been able to do anything about them. It's like they're not even thinking about that. This one tired me. But you know, Oyibo witches, they wrote a book, Harry Potter. They even made a movie, they made millions of dollars. I said, Kai, these Oyibo witches are really, really smart. Whatever happened to African witches now? I'm not saying that witchcraft is good though. How many books have the African witches published? I'm just saying that enough of trying to kill somebody else's child just because they are successful and your own child is yet to be successful. Tomorrow your child will be successful. Yeah, you know me, I'm just keeping it real. So I just heard about that 28-year-old lady from Kenya, the one who killed herself in Britain. It's very, very sad. Sharon Bukoke moved to Britain in 2002. To get her college degree in design and engineering. And right after that, she got a really good job and she was doing really well financially. In fact, the people that knew her, they said each time you meet this lady, she's always smiling. She's like one of the happiest people on earth. But they had no idea that she's been struggling with loneliness for quite some time. Her mom lives in the US, her sister lives in Canada, her husband is getting his master's degree in South Africa. She's in Britain with her brother, but he lives 250 miles away from her. So she's been really, really struggling with loneliness for quite some time, and people didn't know that. Not that she didn't have people around her, she just was missing the people that she cared about, I mean her family. So the loneliness led to great depression, and she's been taking medications for that for quite some time. For more than a year, she's been taking medications for depression. She got so depressed that she started researching on the internet how to commit suicide. Can you believe that? And on that day, she put on really nice outfit, she got her hair done, she fixed her nails, and she put on nice makeup and suffocated herself to death. I mean, seriously, my people, we all know that when we leave Africa to go abroad, be it America, be it Canada, be it Europe, I mean, even Libya, wherever we find ourselves, we all know that it can be very, very lonely because you're starting life all over. But you know, if you ever find yourself in this kind of situation, my people, killing yourself is not the solution. I mean, it doesn't help anybody. It doesn't help you. It doesn't help the people that care about you. In fact, it makes life really, really hard for the people that you leave behind. I really feel bad for her family. Because, you know, I mean, it's true that home is sweet. Africa is really, really sweet. It's like, even if there is no electricity, no good road, whatever, we know how to enjoy. We really know how to enjoy life in Africa. I mean, there's always family members that want to come around you. Sometimes you get tired of them. You tell them, now you have to leave. I need some privacy. But there's always family members around you. If you're having a baby back home, oh my goodness, there's like 20 people that wants to carry your baby at a time. Like, home is always sweet, especially around this Christmas time. You know, I've been thinking about, I need to go home for Christmas. Yes, but after they kidnap Ngozi's mom, I said, hey, me, I'm not going anywhere. This whole thing of you're on your own, it's a completely Western culture. Yes, and I mean, it's good, but it's not always the best. That is why a lot of people are depressed in this country. And so many people have to keep taking medications. It's so funny that all these depression medications have like horrible side effects. Yeah, I watch them on TV sometimes, they are advertising and they will say that side effect may include suicidal thoughts. I said, what is the importance of taking a medication if you will start thinking about killing yourselves? Why do you even need to treat yourself? Seriously. The lady was also on medication for depression. It's really, really sad. I said to myself, all she needed was for her mom to make her some African food. Yeah, just make her some fufu. And you know, hang out with her brothers and her sisters for some days and all the symptoms would disappear. No medication, you don't need any medication. And in case you're watching me and you're lonely, you miss home and there's nobody that can come and hang out with you, just put on some African music. By that time you do that for like 30 minutes, all the symptoms will disappear. My prayer is that African countries will become better. Yeah, so that people can chase their dreams right where their family members are. It's not easy living in another country, my people. No, it's not easy. Until then, though, if you're an African and you're living abroad and you're lonely, please try to find some kind of organization, you know, join a church, join a mosque, wherever you would find people that care about you so that you wouldn't have to deal with loneliness by yourself. You know me? I'm just keeping it real, baby. By the way, Nigerian president had to bury his brother last Saturday, Chief Manny Jonathan. He died after a cardiac arrest at Asorok Hospital. May his soul rest in peace. For some reason, a lot of Nigerians have been focusing on Patience Jonathan's dressing at the funeral service. They're saying that she's overdressed, that it's a funeral service, it's not a naming ceremony or wedding ceremony. Who cares what the first lady wears? Shouldn't you guys be sympathetic towards Jonathan at least? Let the woman be. For once, let the woman be. You always have to say something about this woman. Just be happy for her for once. For once, people, Nigerians, be happy for her for once. At least she's there. She's no longer in Germany. She's there at the funeral service. That's enough to commend. In fact, some went as far as taking a very, very close look at that picture until their eyes saw what is not supposed to see. Yeah, I can't even talk about that. I don't know what these people are looking for. Anyway, what I actually wanted to talk about is that there has been a report circulating that 5 trillion naira has been stolen from government funds since President Jonathan came into power in May 2010. I said, 5 trillion naira? How's that even possible? They said that this money was stolen through fraud, embezzlement, and theft. I said, is it possible for 5 trillion naira to disappear under your nose and you will not know about it? This includes the $6.3 billion that Ribadu revealed that they are stealing from NNPC every year. I mean, that's like 1.2 trillion naira. I mean, how can $6.3 billion disappear every year from the NNPC and nobody would know about it? And then in the report, they added other monies that have been stolen, like the subsidy funds and so many others. That's how they came about 5 trillion naira. So I said, how is it possible for such amounts to disappear under one administration? So Mr. President, you know, me, I have faith in you and I know you are doing your best, but please, you need to step up your game. 5 trillion, it's not a small amount of money. Instead of us going to go and borrow money from China every day, if we can just probe people, this money is still within Nigeria now, if we can just probe the right people, they will fish out this money and we can develop our country with our own money instead of getting ourselves in debt. Put an hold to borrowing money from China until you can figure out what has happened to this 5 trillion naira. Yes, because if you keep borrowing money from China, these people will keep stealing them, yes, and they will keep kidnapping their parents, and they will keep asking for ransom. Yes, you don't want us to be using this money to pay ransom. So please, Mr. President, just step up your game, because you know, I have faith in you. I'm just keeping it real. Before I leave today, I like to read some of your emails. Don't forget, you can email me at adeola@keepingitreal@gmail.com and you can also follow me on Twitter at adeolafayon. So the first one is from Chimbila. Chimbila says, I'm originally from Zambia. I reside in South Africa. I really love your style of presentation. You're funny, entertaining, and definitely very intelligent. Big ups, my dear. Oh, Chimbila. Oh, thank you. Oh, you're so sweet. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. The next one is from Anifowoshi Okure. He's in Japan. I don't like what you did to me, Adeola. Uh-oh. Today, I missed class watching Keeping It Real. Anifowoshi, are you for real? I came to my awareness of time when my friend gave me a call asking how my class was. Alifowoshe, how can you miss your class because you are watching Keeping It Real? I mean, seriously, I mean, I'm glad that you're watching Keeping It Real and please keep watching. But you know, you can't miss your class because of Keeping It Real. I need to come after you and whoop your beer. How can you miss your class? Alifowoshe, next time you get yourself in class, okay, you can watch while you're in class on your laptop when your professor is talking. You can just put on your earphones and yeah, be watching Keeping It Real. But show up in class, okay? For next time, show up in class. I'm just keeping it real. All right, that's all emails that I can read today. Please keep sending them in. I'm gonna try to read as many as possible on the show next week. All right, y'all, it's been real, and I'm keeping it real right up in here. Until next week, I'm gonna see y'all later. Peace out.